Hi everyone, welcome to Neil Talks. My name's Neil and it's time for the IT crowd. We're already in series two, guys. One of the weird things for me about British television is the short series size, only six episodes. That's often the norm for comedies. I know we're getting used to similar things here in North America with prestige format television, a lot more mini-series styled shows, but serial shows 15 years ago running only six episodes, that would have been a complete novelty. Nevertheless, here we are in series two. I am excited about this episode, but I'm also nervous because I've gotten a lot of comments about the IT crowd already. And if anyone's volunteered their own favorite episode, I'm going to say 80% of my comments have said that this is that episode. Episode 1 of Series 2, The Workouting. So I'm expecting very good things. But I'm nervous because if I don't think it's hilarious, then what the heck's wrong with me? That being said, we finished Series 1. On a very funny cliffhanger where our main characters all paired off in unusual situations, woke up the next morning after the office party with, you know, your typical startle screams. And so Jen and Moss ended up together. Roy ended up with the Moss's psychiatrist, who looks exactly like Roy's mom. What's that all about? And Denim and Richmond ended up together. So I don't know if we're picking up straight from that moment or whether there's going to be a time cut or what. Well, this is series two, episode one. We might as well jump right into it. The Workouting. No change to the credits, okay. Change to the set, though.
Hey! I just won 450 quid playing poker.
Well then.
That's my rent sorted this month. Oh, and I can buy that new... Oh no, I've lost it all again.
This is Philip from Six. So, what brings you to my lair? Not that I'm some sort of animal. or maybe I am.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear.
I don't suppose maybe you'd like to come to theatre tomorrow night, maybe, or...
I'd be delighted.
He means me, Moss.
He was looking at me.
Are there any famous people in it?
No.
It's a pass from me, then, thank you.
Laura Knightley's in it.
She's gorgeous. You know what? I will come, Philip, thank you. Great, that's settled, then.
That could have been a date there. Now, it's a...
Workouting. They decluttered the set a bit.
He actually did want to borrow the copy of Heat.
So?
Well, it's just, you know. It's just I don't know many heterosexual men who read Heat.
What? He's gay? Just because he reads Heat magazine?
And goes to the theatre.
Are you sure you're not going along as his gal pal? If you're talking about who I think you're talking about, then the answer is yes, he is gay. Everyone knows, and what's more, he's been gay since Wham.
Why else would he ask me out?
Well, don't take this the wrong way, but could he have thought you were a man?
Hey, where are you lot off to?
Oh, look, Richmond's still alive.
We're going to the theatre. Hey, do you want to come?
No, thank you, and you shouldn't go either.
Why not?
An ill wind is blowing. I trod on a piece of Lego. Oh, it went right in the heel.
Well, that's the worst. Absolutely the worst.
No good can come of your trip to the theatre tonight. No good at all.
Prophecy.
If you ask me. Where's my heat?
Gay and gay musical.
That's quite gay. This must be like the gayest musical ever made. It's got some pretty good reviews.
The audience applauds.
The story of a young man trying to find his sexuality in the uncaring Thatcher years. Warning, includes scenes of graphic homoeroticism.
Oh, no. It's set in the 80s.
There's Philip. Oh, look, he's lurching at that lady. Thank God for that. He's just an ordinary
Or checking out
man.
Her boots.
I know someone who gets the pickle. Sorry, I love doing that to him.
Hey.
Hello, how's it going?
Oh, my God, you're Irish. I love Irish people. They're just mad, aren't they? We're all insane, yep.
Welcome to the United Queendom!
Brilliant.
I'm gonna say he's gay.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
He's my friend.
This is insanely brilliant.
That's not my heart.
Okay, I'm completely satisfied.
Don't leave, it's rude.
Nah, it's too gay for me. Thought I could handle it, but I can't.
It'll be the interval soon.
Well, I'm captivated, Roy.
At least it can't get any worse.
Go, 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 go.
Oh, what happened?
Hello.
Who wears the trousers in this relationship?
What? No, we're not homosexuals.
So you never had a look?
At what?
His bum!
I've seen it when he flossed in front of my desk. Or should he bend over to pick something up? I do like Roy, but I'm not curious. I think it's fabulous. Every value I've ever held has been questioned, and I'm loving it.
I'll wait out here for you, but there is no way I'm going anywhere near that thing.
Oh, you can't leave me alone in there. I don't know what the hell's going on.
I need to wee-wee.
Yeah, me too.
I've got a toilet coming.
Oh, hey, toilet guys.
The toilet guy. Now you've got to tip him. No pressure. This is a rude toilet guy.
Did you go?
No, did you?
No. I just paid £1 not to go to the toilet.
I'm going to use the disabled.
You can't use the disabled.
What? Why not?
You're not disabled. You'll get in trouble.
I think it's okay, isn't it? It's okay. I'm always using the disabled.
It's illegal.
I don't think so.
He's going to get in trouble. Or not. I don't know. There were a bunch of guys in wheelchairs when we first entered. So is he holding up the whole line? Oh, no.
Hello? You all right in there?
Help. I'm disabled.
Sounds disoriented.
Move back from the door.
What? No.
Oh, my God, what happened? Do you have a wheelchair?
Yes.
It was stolen.
Where?
Stolen.
How did they get in?
I don't know.
All right. You're all right.
Oh, this is... Oh, this is so terrible. Look at the crowd of staff.
Excuse me, you know this is a staff toilet.
I'm staff.
You can all go now.
We're not going anywhere until we've got you sorted out.
Oh, the police!
Oh, no!
Everything all right here?
I'm disabled!
Oh, no.
So?
Oh, this is terrible.
Well, just tell us what you can.
Bearded. Red hair. Glasses.
Do you need any help getting home?
No, I'm fine. I'm with people. Here they are now.
Oh, no.
You slacking off in there? Go and get changed.
Oh, God.
Can I have a word?
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Did you not just love it?
Well, no. Maybe you have to be gay.
Well, all I know is I loved every last second of it, and I'm not
usually a fan of musicals.
Hey, do you want to meet the cast?
I have to meet Moss and Roy.
No, they're busy getting onto a disabled bus and getting into uniform. Oh my god. Oh, they're not leaving. They are not leaving.
Hey, listen, I told the cast about what happened, and they told me to get you all to come back and meet them.
Yay! Oh, man. Oh, I'm dying of embarrassment.
Darling.
Listen, can't talk at the moment. Got a disabled group coming in for a chat. Here they are now.
Someone stole his wheelchair.
Really? Did you see who it was?
Red-bearded man.
Uh-huh. How long have you been disabled? And how did it happen, if that's not a rude question?
Acid. 100 to 1.
You look like you could do with a drink.
Whiskey.
Excuse me.
Yes, miss.
Okay. Can I have a double whiskey, please? Thank you.
You're very welcome, madam.
How are you? It must be so difficult being gay and disabled.
Very difficult.
What's the matter?
I don't know.
A little birdie told me that you couldn't make the show tonight. So I've got you 2 tickets for tomorrow.
Oh no! Yay!
Couple of folders.
Is he from the newspaper?
Yes, he's from the Standard.
Oh god. No.
Very funny, you Irish.
Oh, I'm a bit tired. Can I have a wheelchair too?
Come on, stop buzzing around. I wanna go.
Oh my god.
I guess this is goodnight.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, for God's sake, are you gay? Are you a gay man?
No!
What on earth made you think I was gay?
Well, oh, you know, I didn't just...
Can a straight man not have homosexual friends? And since when was tickling gay? Come here.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess you just threw me when you borrowed that copy of Heed.
Oh, God, it's true. I'm gay. I thought I could make it work between us because you looked a bit like a man.
Oh, my God. Oh, his look. Just so inspirational, so brave, so strong.
Right, lads, let's get a sing song going. It's a long way back to Manchester.
Night, Moss.
Night, Millie, you be good.
Not if I can help it.
The theatre.
Oh, no. Oh, this theatre. Oh, man. Okay, I get it. I totally get it. There was about that 2-minute segment from when Roy was wheeled into the after party through Jen saying hi to him, finding out why he was paralyzed, to getting him a drink from Moss. That might be the best payoff to a long setup, which was basically the previous 10 or 15 minutes of the episode, that I've seen in a long, long time of comedy. just the additional laugh when she turns to place that order and it's Moss taking it. It was brilliant. Brilliantly shot by holding back on that reveal, but not unnaturally so. Damn, just... I mean, it's pure sitcom, but sitcom, when it's done well, is as funny as anything. And damn, it's hilarious. Just what would happen if we put Roy in a wheelchair? How long would he go with it? You know, these are the discussions they're having in the writer's room before they start the episode. And they're like, oh, he would not give up on that. He would stick it out. Man, just hilarious. Thank you guys. Thank you for turning me on to this show. I get why that may be the first episode you guys think of when you think of this show. And what I love is the live studio audience broke character. That's the button on it all. You know, the live studio audience, it's genuine laughter, don't get me wrong, but like the audience gets warmed up before the show starts, so they're already in a laughing mood, and they're expressly told before filming starts that be sure to be vocal, don't hold back, basically. But I love the end of this. When Moss does his theater and then falls behind the bar, you hear hoots and hollers from the audience, whistles, like cheers, because that live studio audience realized they had seen something special. And it's especially hard with the live studio audience because it's not filmed in 22 minutes. We switch from set to set, there's multiple takes, etc., etc. The filming may take hours and hours. And you may have heard the joke 3, 4, or 5 times before the take that ends up on screen. So the rhythm is hindered. And yet that response at the very end was 100% genuine. And whew, so well deserved. Great episode. It's a great auger of things to come this series and for the duration, and not what I was expecting at all, because I was expecting some sort of follow-up to the season one finale. I would have thought there would be some acknowledgement of what happened at the end of that episode, but no, which takes us back to classic sitcom. There is no real through line. There are these characters, and they get into wacky hijinks each and every week. But whether what order you watch them in, not vital. Anyway, expertly crafted, awesomely performed, hilarious as heck. Tough to beat an episode like that. Thank you guys so much for spending a little time with me here on Neil Talks today. I'd love to hear your thoughts about this episode. I imagine it's considered just a classic, but tell me. And if you haven't yet already, don't forget to like and subscribe. Check out my Patreon if you're so inclined. Patreon.com/Neil Talks, where you can see my full-length reactions and get early access to all of my reactions. And until next time, everybody, take care, stay healthy, and we'll see you soon. Cheers.